afternoon. Welcome to Bangor Academy and Sixth Form College. We are delighted that you could attend this afternoon's prize giving, and are especially pleased to welcome our guest speaker, Mrs. Anne Connolly, the Chair of the Northern Ireland Policing Board. Some of you will notice that there is a new format with the distribution of awards and presentations. However, as usual, after the prize giving, everyone is welcome for tea and for refreshments in the Grand Floor Canteen. The principal, Mr. Pitts, will now give his annual report.
Board of Governors, guest speaker Mrs. Connolly, guests, parents and students of Bangor Academy. I want to start this afternoon with a quote from a parent of one of our new Year 8 students. She wrote, "Positivity, drive, determination for success are oozing from this school, and I'm delighted for my daughter to be taking her 7-year educational journey with Bangor Academy and Sixth Form College." And this summarises my feelings after my first year as principal of Bangor Academy. Staff, students, parents and the wider community are overwhelmingly positive about our school. And like this parent, I'm delighted to be part of Bangor Academy's educational journey. This really is an incredible school. And I hope this afternoon to provide a brief insight into the wide range of success we've experienced over the previous academic year. We're honoured today to have as our guest Anne Connolly, Chair of the Northern Ireland Policing Board. And I'd also like to welcome all guests who've given up their time to join us in our celebration. Amongst the principals, board officers, MLAs and the Mayor is a truly special guest, Liz Beach. She retired last year after a career dedicated to this school. Liz started teaching at the Girls High in 1977 after attending the school as a student and eventually becoming head girl. It was a privilege working with Liz, if only for 1 year, and I'm delighted she could join us this afternoon. I said last year that Bangor Academy is in a period of change, and I'm pleased to say that this remains the case. Education should always be changing, and it's essential that we embrace the challenges and opportunities of change to ensure we continue to provide the highest quality comprehensive education for all of our students. You'll hear about a school which has already embarked on this journey of high aspirations, high expectations, and of continuous self-improvement. And whilst we all acknowledge that success in a school or of an individual student is more than a set of exam results, I do want to congratulate staff, parents, and students who all worked together last year to help us achieve the highest ever GCSE results and A-level results at Bangor Academy. It is a privilege to lead such a school, and I'm confident change will lead to new opportunities, experiences, and even greater success in the future. But joining a school as a new principal is an interesting experience. Every conversation, every meeting, gives you an opportunity to gain insight into a school, its ethos, and the people involved. And I'll share with you an example of an early meeting I had, which provided me with a really clear glimpse into the quality and motivation of our staff. We're part of a network called Business in the Community, and it involves working with a partner company, Fujitsu, which is one of the world's largest IT companies, on a number of initiatives to support our students. And it's great that some of those are here today. The staff and students are encouraged to volunteer and get involved in community events. And to this end, we decided to sign up for the Action Cancer Care Shop Challenge, which is run by Business in the Community. This is a fantastic event which gives companies and organisations the chance to take over their local Action Cancer Shop for a day in competition with other companies. And at this meeting to discuss whether we were in a position to take part in the competition, a comment was made from a member of staff which sums up Bangor Academy's ambitions. This member of staff said, "If we're going to enter it, we're going to win it." And this was reflected throughout the year. Staff at Bangor Academy don't settle for okay or satisfactory. An exceptionally driven group of people who constantly strive to be even better. And I want to thank all of them for their dedication, enthusiasm, passion for the school, and perhaps most importantly, their sense of fun. Staff here enjoy their job and will do everything they can to make sure every student achieves success. I love working here, and it's a delight to lead such an impressive group of people. As I said, staff take pride in every situation, and they pursue excellence in all areas. As you've already heard, we're trying something different today with a prize presentation broken into sections with accompanying videos. The quality of the work that's gone into this demonstrates the commitment of all staff, which will be evident throughout the afternoon. And the first video we're going to watch is one that we submitted as part of our Action Cancer Care Shop Challenge.
But today's a really exciting day. We've taken over the Action Counter Shop, and you can see behind me that there's all sorts of events going on. One of my challenges today is to choose something that represents Bangor Academy and the ethos of the school and how it links to Action Cancer. And cancer is something that's really important that we raise awareness of it and Action Cancer, all the work that they do. We've got 1,500 students in the school and over 150 staff, and it's inevitable that at certain times in that sort of community, people will be affected by cancer at some point. And anything we can do to support the charity, raise awareness, and just help whatever we can, from helping out with raising money to collecting bags, collecting items for the charity, it's brilliant to be part of it. So I'm really excited about today, and I'm really looking forward to raising lots of money and winning the Action Cancer Care Shop Challenge.
In terms of the Action Cancer Challenge, we were awarded third place. And whilst this didn't meet the initial target of winning, we were only just narrowly beaten by Marks and Spencers and Boots, and that gives you a sense of our incredible achievement. But the competition really galvanised our staff, and whilst the award was given this academic year, the charity event started last year from sponsored walks, as you've seen, car washing, car boot sales, and loads of other things. And it would be unfair to mention any particular member of staff, but I would like to highlight Lynn Kingham, who volunteered to organise all of the sponsored walks, which resulted in over 1,000 students taking part. And altogether, the school raised just under £18,000, which is a phenomenal achievement. And volunteering and taking part in the wider community plays a really important part in the education of every student at Bangor Academy. We're part of the Millennium Volunteers Programme, and last year, 8 students reached the 200 Hours Award, with many more leaving school with 150 Hours Awards, which are recognised by employers. Dara Ison, in Year 14, was selected to represent County Down in the first All-Ireland World War I Adopt-a-Soldier programme, and this culminated in her travelling to France to find the grave of her chosen soldier, who originated from Hollywood, and died on the first day of the Battle of the Somme, and this project was recently featured in an RTE documentary. Last year, over 400 students took part in work experience, and 2 Year 13 students in the summer took up Nuffield research placements at the Queen's Marine Laboratory. Both received Gold Crest Awards. We have close link with the university, and it's great that some of them are here today. We're part of Queen's University Widening Participation Programme, both junior and senior levels, and we received a Queen's plaque for student participation in programmes organised by the university. And as recognition of our involvement with the RAF, we also received the RAF Platinum Award for our careers links. And we continue to encourage all students to develop a wider cultural experience, and once again, we received the International Schools Award. Our Confucius Hub, operating in conjunction with Ulster University, continues to grow. We've increased the number of partner primary schools who receive Mandarin teaching. We now have 4 teachers of Mandarin based at Bangor Academy. We've also introduced an evening class open to the community. For the European Day of Languages in September, we invited Key Stage 3 students to take part in activities, songs and food tasting in the Languages Department. Ms. Burns continued to develop links with a school in the Netherlands as part of our e-twinning programme. And this project took place over 2 years between the school in the Netherlands and 9A1 at Bangor Academy. And over the 2 years, both classes exchanged profiles and photos, presented information on their country, culture, customs, and favourite foods. They Skyped each other and took part in various other activities. In April 2014, the class from the Netherlands visited Bangor Academy and took part in lessons, a tour of Bangor and Belfast, and visited the Titanic Centre. In April 2015, 9A1, by that stage of 10A1, visited their college for lessons, a history tour on bikes, and the highlight of the trip was a visit to Amsterdam and to Anne Frank's house. This was a memorable experience for both staff and students, and a new project is currently underway with a new group of students from the Netherlands coming to visit us next year. But before we give out our Key Stage 3 awards, there'll be another short video giving you a taste of the quality of our Key Stage 3 experience.